أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهد الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن سيدنا محمد عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، we give thanks to Almighty Allah. We praise Him. We glorify Him. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah upon our noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family and his companions to the day of judgment. My brother and sister in Islam, Allah always remind me and you in every single Friday. Almighty Allah says in Al-Quran al-Azim, "Oh, you believe, fear Allah, verify you. Fear Allah. And do not return to me, alas, except you die in the sins of Islam." My brothers and sisters in Islam, today's, inshallah's khutbah is about the nature of human being that Almighty Allah created within me and you. But Almighty Allah wants us to be in the middle. This is what we need to talk about today. Why? Because there are many things that we are doing now or in the past that we regret on, either by decision making or statements or our action, to the extent that today we are paying for that. We are in the state of regret. Why have I done this for? It could be years. So that's the reason why this khutbah need to do as a wake up for me and you. Almighty Allah says in Al-Quran al-Azim, Almighty Allah says, وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانَ عَجُولًا. This is the topic. Almighty Allah says, وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانَ عَجُولًا. Man by nature is rush, hurry. When you make your one decision, maybe then you hurry up to make decisions. Maybe then you hasty to make decisions. Now you are regretting. But Almighty Allah told you, That insan ajula. This is our nature. This fitra that all men are created in me and you. But all men want us to be in the middle, like I mentioned previously. How are we going to know this? Almighty Allah, let us know in hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Almighty Allah created Prophet Adam in order for me and you to know that وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانَ عَجُولًا. When Almighty Allah created Prophet Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, then Almighty Allah blown his ruh, spirit, soul into him. But that rule starts from the top. Immediately, when Prophet Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah blows his ruh into Adam, when Adam saw in Jannah then the tree of fruit, Prophet Adam alayhi salatu wasalam attached him then to that fruit. But now ruin means that spirit is going down. When it is, the ruin soul go run into his body. Now it was hunger in order to get food. When the ruh spirit moved to his leg, he rushed, stand up in order to get what? To get the food. Why? Because Almighty Allah has already said that he created it from rush hasty. If that happened to the Prophet of Allah, what of me and you? It's part of the nature. In fact, Almighty Allah advised Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Al-Quran too. Almighty Allah said to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, oh, Ya Rasulullah, this advice, let me give you warning about what happened to your brother in the past. Mean that Prophet Yunus, your brother, my prophet, like you, he did not listen to my direction, to my instruction, before he made move. And he spent sometimes in darkness of the ocean and the fish. That's why Almighty Allah says in Al-Quran al-Azim, فَاسْبِرْ لِحُكْمِ رَبِّكَ وَلَا تَكُنْ كَصَحِبِ الْعُودِ. Almighty Allah says to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah says, فَاسْبِرْ, be patient. In any of your decisions, be patient. فَاسْبِرْ لِحُكْمِ رَبِّكَ, and wait for the command of your Lord. وَلَا تَكُنْ كَصَاحِبِ الْعُودِ. Almighty Allah says, and don't be like the man in the fish. Almighty Allah is referring to Prophet Yunus. My brother and sister in Islam. But today, me and you, in time of our ibadah, remember, I said previously that Almighty wants us to be in the middle, which inshallah I will explain so that we can understand better. But today, this negative aspect, in time of our ibadah, we knew how much we pray our salat. Do we pray our salat with concentration and focus in order to please Almighty Allah? Or we are rushing? Or we are hasting because of what we want to get? We arise this Allah, we are in the front of Almighty Allah, we stand before Him, O Allah, and we are saying, Idina Sirat al Mustaqim, Iyaka Na'budu wa Iyaka Nasta'in. But still, our mind is still divided. Imagine, my brothers in Islam, to the day that when we want to recite some surah, we know how we read it. Fasting, rushing. In a minute, we finish our salah and we leave. And this is Allah. This is Allah. Even Almighty Allah addressed that in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In a positive way that Prophet Muhammad wants to do his own. But listen to what Almighty Allah said to Prophet Muhammad. When an angel came to Prophet Muhammad in order to treat Prophet Muhammad, how he's going to read the Al-Quran and Azim. How are we going to read Al-Quran al-Azim? But when Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wants to catch up so that he will not forget after you believe, then Almighty Allah acknowledge that. Then Almighty Allah says to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَلَا تَعَجَّلْ بِالْقُرْآنِ مِنْ قَبْلَ أَنْ يُقِدَ إِلَيْكِ وَحْيُهُ وَقُلْ رَبِّ زِدْنِي عِلْمًا. Almighty Allah said to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَلَا تَعَجَّلْ بِالْقُرْآنِ. Almighty Allah said, do not rush, do not eat with Al-Qur'an al-Azim. Why Jibreel was reading to you? Almighty Allah said to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we are at the intention of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's a positive way. But Almighty Allah said, no, be patient. Min Qabla, when revelation come to you, before it completed that revelation, don't see anything. Listen. Min Qabla, the Ilayka, wa ayyuh wa kul rabbi, after that, your part is to say to Almighty Allah, O Almighty Allah, increase me in knowledge. Just follow the instruction. My brother and sister in Islam. And what of this, my brother and sister in Islam? Today, we are rushing. See what is going on all over the world. We want to acquire property, more money, income, increase of income. We don't even care about barakah, blessing. Either halal or haram, we don't even care. We forget the qadr of Almighty Allah, destiny of Almighty Allah upon us, which Almighty Allah has already known 50,000 years before Almighty Allah created this world into each every one. But we forgot that we don't wait. We rush to everything. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in one of profound hadith, inna ruha al-qudus nafas fi ruhi anna nafsa lan tamuta atta tastakmila rizqaha wa ajalaha fattaqullah wajmilu fi talab. Prophet Muhammad said, Angel Jibril revealed to me, blown to me, to my mind, saying that all material that said, your Lord said, Angel Jibril told me, that no human being in this one, no human being, everyone that all mankind has created shall die until he or her has to finish or consume in time of sustenance, finish, completed before he return to all mankind. Almighty Allah has already made that. And our provision and everything, Almighty Allah has already passed everything for us. This is the word of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But today we forget that. That's number two. And number three, we always not patient when we have been asking something from Almighty Allah. Yes, we are praying five times daily. Yes, we are making our zakat, our siyam, everything accordingly. But when it comes to our demand from Almighty Allah, then Almighty Allah delivers. Now we react to Almighty Allah. I've been watching Almighty Allah. I attended this gathering. But still, Almighty Allah does not answer my prayer. Started blaming Almighty Allah. Faliyasubillah. We are asked, Almighty Allah, for all of the believers, Allah has agenda, good agenda for them. We may not know what Almighty Allah has for me and you. That's why me and you have to be patient, not to rush, not to rush at all. Almighty Allah says in Al-Quran Azim, Asa an takra'u shay'a wa huwa khayru lakum. Perhaps, maybe Almighty Allah has good agenda for you at so time you did not know. That's what Almighty Allah says. Asa an takra'u shay'a wa huwa khayru lakum. And let's say, in many cases, we may dislike something which is good for you. Suppose that Almighty Allah has given your wish. Maybe it's going to turn to something that can ruin you or your family at that moment. But just keep asking Almighty Allah. Then Almighty Allah give us the good example in the story of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam and Khidr. Remember, in Surah Al-Kahf, Prophet Musa alayhi salam went to heaven in order to acquire the knowledge. But on their way, they want to pass an ocean. Meaning that the sailor, the owner of the ship, knew knew the Hebrew in advance. And he gave them the free ride. Just let go. I knew you. So on their way, then Hebrew started vandalize the ship. But Prophet Musa said, why did you do those people? Why are you doing this for their sheep? Why? But due to the knowledge of Almighty Allah that revealed to Khidr, that's the reason why he did that. On no knowledge. So later on, when Khidr started to interpret the meaning to Prophet Musa alayhi salatu, he finally knows that, oh, this is the reason why. Why? Because at that moment, there was a king that waiting in order to seize the clean and the brown sheep from anyone in that town. Which Almighty Allah has already let Khidr know, so that when he vandalized, he will not seize that ship from the owner of that ship. In order to save that family, because they are good family, at least they will still use it for their income. What if the king sees everything? What left? Nothing. But Allah knew this knowledge in advance. So similar things may happen to me and you, my brother and sister in Islam. That's why any position we find ourselves, just keep going and ask Almighty Allah to help you, to assist you. Believe me, Allah have good for you. Final one. My brother and sister in Islam. You see, we are, inshallah, we are now approaching the month of Ramadan. This is Rajab. This is Rajab. Let's try our best. Let's try our best. Audio. In this case, we have to audio. You see the difference now. This one, we have to audio to do it. If you hold someone's money, return it quick. You never know what's going to happen tomorrow. If you do something that has already hurt in the past for your friends, for your family, for anyone in your community, try to apologize. You never know what's going to happen in a second. Who you all mean to learn this. Try that. If you have some trust with you, then return it quickly. You see, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam just finished Salatul Asr. This is unusual. Then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left the masjid and ran home. Then many of Sahaba were so shocked. What's going on? Then when Prophet Muhammad came back, Prophet Muhammad said, I knew that you guys were worried about what I did. You see, there was the gold that I kept at home. So I have to distribute it quickly because I don't want to spend another night in my room. This is the prophet of Allah, my brother and sister. So that tells us what we need to do at this moment in Iran. May Almighty Allah make it easy for me and you. ربنا اغفر لنا واخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. الحمد لله الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. ربنا اغفر لنا واخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. ربنا عليك توكلنا وإليك أنبنا وإليك المصير. ربنا اكشف عنا عذاب إنا مؤمنون. ربنا آتينا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون وأقيموا